Ladies and gentlemen, just be patient. We'll be starting in a few minutes, in about 3 to 4 minutes, so just be patient with us. Graveside celebration for the life of Mr. Quincy Oliver Richardson. This time we can bow our heads in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you this day. We thank you for being a sovereign God. We thank you for being a comforting God. We thank you, God, for your hand of protection over this family. We thank you, God, for being eyes that they cannot see with their own and being hands that they cannot reach on their own. And God, we bless them today. And we give them the peace that surpasses all understanding. In your name we pray. Amen. This time we'll have the Old Testament reading, Isaiah 41 and 10. It says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." Isaiah 41 and 10. The New Testament reading is as such. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 54 through 57. "When the perishable puts on the imperishable, and the mortal puts on immortality, then shall come the pass, the saying is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." Family and friends, we are here this afternoon, not understanding always what God does, but we understand who God is. And when we understand who God is, even when it's hard to understand why he does what he does, we understand that God still is the strength of our life. And that God, and what I charge all of you to do, is that not just be here for the family on today, not just be here for April on today, but after the many calls stop and after the chicken leaves the house, that you still call and check and give her strength every day. Because if you've ever experienced death in your life, although it's God's doing, death is not easy. But today, those family and friends who are surrounded here and co-workers and many people who have gathered, we're here today to show her and her family and her children and the siblings, all those people, that they are not here alone. So if anything else I leave you with today, to make sure that you let her know that she is not alone. At this time, we're going to follow the order of the program. We're going to give you about 2 minutes to read the obituary silently. And then after that you will hear a selection from Minister Joshua Lattimore, followed by words of comfort by me.
I'll be committed to you. I'll never leave you. Nothing in this world could make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what the test, you won't be lonely. Because Because forever is a long time. And that's how long I'll love you. That's how long I'll love you. Forever. Forever is a long time. That's how long I'll love you. Yes, that's how long I'll love you. Forever. I'll be committed to you. No, I'll never leave you. No, nothing in this world could make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what the test, you won't be lonely. Because forever is a long time. And that's how long I'll love you. That's how long I'll love you. Forever. Forever is a long time. That's how long I'll love you. Yes, that's how long I'll love you. Forever. Because forever is a long time. And that's how long he'll love you. That's how long he'll love you. Forever.
Thank God, because God will always love us forever. I want to leave the family and those of you who are listening just with a few words of comfort. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I want to encourage you today, family. I want to encourage you, family and friends. I want to encourage you, April, as we gather this morning to remember the life of this great man, that God will be your refuge and your strength. We are ever embracing the arms of our everlasting Lord. Clearly, this man, this great man, had a reflection on all of us that his life touched us. I recall hearing April the night that I went to the house of the day that he passed, and she talked about how he decided to go to the store with her, and he does something that he never did, and he went to the store with her that night, the night before, because he understood the reflection and the life, and something in him made him share a memory. I want all of you to understand that all we have is God and memory. So I charge all of you to make sure that you take the memories that he's left with us and carry those on. I want you to understand that God is a God who will do what he says he'll do in the 23rd Psalm. If you put your trust in him, that he'll give you mercy and comfort in the time of grief. Listen to what the 23rd Psalm says. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou dost prepare a table for me in the presence of mine enemies, but thou hast anointed my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. This psalm assures us that God is there to guide and lead us through all times of trouble and hardship. He is a friend that sticks close to us. April, he is a friend that will provide for us. He is a friend that will love us. And even when we face these troubling days with hurts that are all painful and real, he promises never to leave us and that he'll always be by our side. And all we need to run to him for is our refuge and our strength. I want to close with this poem of comfort and encouragement by Edgar Guest. When sorrow comes, and come it must, in God man must place his trust. There's no power of mortal speech, the anguish of his soul to reach. No voice, however sweet and low, can comfort him or ease the blow. He cannot from his fellow men take strength that will sustain him then. with all that kindly hands will do and all that love may offer to, he must believe throughout the test that God has willed it for his best. No words which we have the power to say can take away the sting of grief. That power that marks the sparrow's fall must comfort and sustain us all. When sorrow comes, as it and come it must, in God man must place his trust, and only he may stand who has faith on which to lean. Family, friends, April, Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. April, I want to encourage you this afternoon that God is going to give you peace through all of this. In your grief, if you can't turn to anybody else, you can run to God. In God, there is your hope. In God, there is your strength. In God, there your life lies, and God will uphold you with all his hands. Let us pray. Almighty God, it is you we hope and run to today in our time of trouble. Only you can lead us through this time of change and uncertainty. Therefore, God, let us know that you understand how we feel and that your enduring peace and presence lives within us. Father, I need you to bless this family, bless this wife, bless these children, bless these siblings and cousins and aunts and nieces and friends and family as their hearts are laid heavy as we lay this great man to rest today. But God, may your peace and assurance develop in their lives today and always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
This time we'll now have the committal this time. It is here that we separate ourselves from the body which once housed this great man, Quincy Richardson. Here we commit the body back to the dust it came from, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. The spirit and soul we leave with God who made and formed us. May we that are alive remain taken to heart, for we know that this appointed time remains for each and every one of us. Let us here renew our commitment to the Lord who created us, died for us, and called us into divine fellowship with him, and commit to do with all of our might what our hands find to do while we are still in these earthly bodies. And may our trust be in the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. Family, may the Lord bless you and keep your hearts. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the grace of Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Family, at this time, I'm going to give the benediction and I'll turn over to the hands of the mortician. Lord, we thank you again for this day. We thank you for this family. We thank you for the life of Quincy. We thank you, God, for the life that he touched. We thank you for the memories that he left. God, I pray that you never leave anyone who is here today. Show them your why by showing them who you are. We love you, and we take your peace and your comfort and your strength with us as we leave this place today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
To the family, on behalf of our director, the entire staff of Perry J. Brownfield, we'd like to take the opportunity to thank you all for allowing us to be a part of the beautiful home and to the team of love. We thank you. We ask God to continue to teach you and walk with you all in the days to come. God bless you all.
Everyone, at this time, that concludes the graveside ceremony for Mr. Quincy. At this time, if you still care to share with the family, you may do so at this time.